Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today I am back with another new releases video for you all. This new releases day, I'm going to be showing you guys all of my new July budget kits as well as financial stickers. So without any further ado, let's go ahead and get started. I have all of my stickers here right next to me, as well as I will show you guys how these look in both the 7x9 as well as 8.5x11 planner at the end of the video. But for the month of July, I went ahead and chose two designs for my washi kits, which are very, very different, and you guys will soon see that. The main reason was because I feel like whenever we think about July here in the US, we think about 4th of July and how fitting that theme would be for a washi kit. And so I did want to incorporate that aspect of the month of July, but I also wanted to give my international subbies and customers another option. So I have two different washi patterns. I'm also releasing a brand new sticker sheet, and I have made tiny changes to a couple of the other sheets. I think first I'll go ahead and show you guys the smaller sheets that I have. In the past, I have offered several sticker sheets with the Erin Condren monthly color, because if you guys don't know, most of my stickers are geared towards the deluxe monthly planners by Erin Condren. Of course, you can use these stickers, and I've had customers come to me telling me that these stickers also do fit in the happy planners. So if you guys have a happy planner, you guys can also use these stickers as well as any other planner really. But I used to come out with three different sheets, and those were my work labels, my appointment labels, and these no page scripts. Since I do know that the deluxe monthly planner should be coming out anytime within the next month, and since there has been a size difference in the appointment labels and the hourly life planner, I've decided to just nix both my work and appointment labels and just offer the no page script sticker. So I still will be offering this. This has not changed. So this is the only kind of July monthly color, although honestly all of my other stickers go really perfectly with the July color. Aside from this smaller sticker sheet, I'm also going to show you guys the Bildu stickers and how these look. So as you guys can see, the July monthly color is almost exactly this color, but like a shade off. So I do offer, as you guys know, my stickers in three different sizes. So this would be for the 7x9 planner, this is for the petite monthly planner, and this would be for the 8.5x11 size. So those would be the smaller sticker sheets that I offer. Next, I'm going to be talking about the two different washi patterns I will be offering. Like I mentioned, one of them is going to be very geared towards, of course, 4th of July. And this is how the first sheet looks. As you guys can see, it has the white and red stripes as both the two thick washi strips as well as the one thin washi strip here. And it also has a bunch of both silver as well as the blue stars. I really loved this washi design, and as soon as I saw it, I was like, that is so perfect. And it's really perfect too because I love the color red, so I think it goes very well for this month. And then the other two thin washi strips have silver glitter. I just thought that that would go really perfectly with this kit. So that's how the first washi kit is going to look. And then the second washi kit is this beautiful floral washi kit. As you guys can see, these are two very, very different designs, but they both do go along with the same color trackers, which I will show you guys in a second. So for this, I decided to go for this blue flowers on top of a minty kind of green background. And then the other two thin washi strips are that seafoam blue kind of color that we had for last month, for the month of June. So I just decided to pair it up with that. I've been really fond of using glitter in my washi kits, if you guys have been watching my past couple of new releases, so that's kind of what I still want to stick with. Aside from that, I will show you guys the rest of the kits. I have my weekly check-in kit. So for the floral pattern, this is how the weekly check-in kit would look. So as you guys can see, this is a dark navy blue color that's going to go along with all the white lettering inside of them. If you guys have not noticed, I am now doing digital listings for my kits. So the colors that show up in the digital listings are definitely going to vary because of the saturation and brightness in both your phone and computer screen, as well as when it's printed on the sticker paper that I use, which is, if you guys don't know, removable matte paper. It is definitely not as dark as it looks in the digital listing. So that's kind of why I also like to make these videos, so that you guys can get to see exactly, or as exact as you can see, the actual colors. So that is how the weekly check-in is going to look. And then for the stripes color, the Page Flex, of course, are going to be this silver glitter one. So definitely goes, I think, with both of the washi kits, although they're very, very different. Aside from that, I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys the washi kits that I'll be offering. So this is your budget kit for the floral print, and this is how the stripes print looks. I do offer my budget kits in two formats. This will be having both your bills and expenses all in one strip, and then this will be having your expenses separated by variable and fixed. I feel like the thing I love the most about my budget kits is that it does come with a correlating squared pattern box, as well as you get some deco to decorate your budget spread. And this will be the variable and fixed expense budget kit for the stripes washies. I do offer all of these sheets a la carte, as well as I have a special offer for a deluxe budget kit, which comes with a washi kit, a weekly check-in kit, and a budget kit. So I believe you do get a discount if you purchase those three sheets in that listing. Next, I have other trackers that I typically like to have, like my sinking funds, and I have made a couple of tiny changes that you guys are probably not going to realize, but I just went ahead and made the spacing a little bit better than what it has been. So all of these changes and the new addition to the financial trackers are going to be effective as of this month, so the month of July. I also will be having in a listing your debt trackers. So I have here your debt tracker, which I also made sure that the spacing between the different categories and sections were a little bit better when writing down. So this is your debt tracker. You have debt snowball, and in that same listing you will have debt avalanche. Aside from that, I have a spending tracker. We have a variable income. And then last of those trackers is the new addition, and that is a savings tracker. Now, I've been getting asked to make a savings tracker for quite some time, and I thought that it would just be a perfect thing to come out with for, of course, the month of July, because by then I will be moving into a new deluxe monthly planner. So I definitely want to set up a savings tracker. And the way that I set this up was that it is in the monthly color, and I soon will be adding this for all of the patterns in my neutrals collection. And so the way that I wanted to use this was to have it within the monthly pages and have a section for your account. So you could either be taking or putting in money into different accounts, like your emergency fund, your regular savings account. I know myself, I have like a moving out savings account, so I would put it in here. I also have a section for you to put the date that you're either taking money out or you're adding money in, and your beginning, of course, plus your minus, and your ending. I believe a couple of you guys have requested a savings tracker, and I believe one of you guys told me that it could be exactly the same things that I had in my sinking funds, but I definitely thought that it would be necessary to add a date kind of section to that, just so that you know which days you're taking money out of your savings or putting money in. So this savings tracker is going to be in the same listing as my variable income and spending tracker, if you guys were wondering. So that is a new addition to my new budget kits. So I will be making those for every single month, starting with the month of July. And now last but not least, for new kind of changes to the sticker sheets in my shop, I am coming out with paycheck to paycheck budgeting stickers. These are pretty much the same as I've had them in the past, but the only new thing is that I've now included a total income header section, which before wasn't included. I've gotten this requested so many times by subscribers and also patrons that I thought it was definitely a time to add that in, since I was already making other changes and additions. So this is how the new paycheck to paycheck stickers are going to look. So we have first, second, third, and fourth. And once again, they're all going to have the four different headers. So that is the small little addition to these paycheck trackers. Aside from that, I also have budgeting scripts like these that have budget, weekly check-in, transaction log, sinking funds, debt tracker, and debt payoff plans. And then I have the first through fourth paycheck scripts and the first and second paycheck scripts. I typically have all these three in one listing, just for anybody who doesn't want to, let's say, pick up the other kits and just have these scripts. And then last but not least, I have here my monthly sticker sheets. I of course wanted to do the two different prints that I have available as washi kits, as monthly kits. So this is how the stripes kind of 4th of July inspired monthly washi kit is going to look. In that same listing, you'll be able to choose between this one or this beautiful floral one. I think this is so, so pretty. I might just end up using this one. As well as you will also be able to choose if you would like to add an add-on sheet to your cart. And so this will be the add-on sheet that correlates with the stripes washi. The only small change that I made for this was that I included a couple of other dots that you could cover, let's say the days that are not in the month with. So I believe in the month of July, it has 4 days that are not in that month. So I went ahead and just included 5 little dots in there, and that should be more than enough to cover those. You get some labels, you get 8 bilju stickers, 2 extra washi strips, date dots, and some script stickers. And then this is how the floral add-on sheet will look. Aside from this, I also give you guys an option to just purchase the date dots by themselves if you, let's say, you just want to purchase the washi kit and not the whole add-on sheet. With that being said, that is pretty much all that I have for this video. I am quickly going to show you guys how these look in the planner, but I do want to mention that as of now, all of the stickers are going out at a 1 to 2 week processing time. I know that there's been delays with USPS and just all shipments in general, so please do take that into consideration. As I've mentioned before, I like to come out with stickers this far in advance so that you guys make sure to purchase them as soon as you can. So I have here my 8.5 by 11 planner, which is pretty huge. So I'm gonna try to, and here I have both the stripes washi as well as the correlating bills and expenses budget kit. So this is how it will look with the beautiful silver glitter washi. Super cute. And then for the 7x9, I went ahead and used the floral washi. So this is how this looks. I think this is so, so beautiful, and I'm glad that I went ahead and chose the two different washi kits that I did. I also do want to mention that, of course, by the time that you guys are watching this video, all of my new releases for the month of July are now going to be live over on my standalone shop, raminarosa.com. I will be closing my Etsy shop at the end of this month, and for that reason, I decided to not put these new releases in there, but rather just keep whatever is in there, and whatever ends up selling will sell through there. So if you guys would like to pick up any July stickers, make sure to head on over to my standalone shop. As always, I will leave a link for that down below in the description box, so make sure you go ahead and check that out. If you guys enjoyed this video, please don't forget to give it a huge thumbs up, as well as subscribe to my channel if you guys are not subscribed already. Let me know if you have any feedback for me. You guys know that I like to work and create more stickers off of your feedback, so if you guys want me to add something else into the stickers that I'm now offering that will work for you, go ahead and let me know, and hopefully I will get to see you guys on my next video. Bye guys.